Oh my goodness, I can't believe I'm saying goodbye to this beautiful truck. It has served me well for years, gone thousands of miles, taken us to places that we never would have been able to get to without it. Goodbye. So yes, we are trading in our truck, so stay tuned to find out what we get, and stick around to the end. We'll talk a little bit about some of the towing numbers and features that we like, so stay tuned. I can't believe the day is here. Time to say goodbye. This has been such a good truck, but it is time to upgrade. Oh my gosh, there it is. What have I done? So yes, it's official. We have upgraded to a Ram 3500 turbo diesel. We went for it. We wanted to upgrade the truck, so we figured we might as well future-proof what we're doing, because we do eventually want to get a heavier trailer or even a fifth wheel. And if you put that much weight in the bed, you're really going to be over your payload capacity in a hurry. So even a 2500 is not always going to be good enough for a fifth wheel, for that weight in the bed. So we went with the 3500 to get that higher payload capacity, which this particular truck, with the setup that we have, which is the 6.7 liter turbo diesel, it is not the high output, it is not the Eisen transmission, it's just the standard turbo diesel that Ram uses. I have the numbers here for the Ram. For our particular setup with the single rear wheel and the 3.73 axle ratio, gross vehicle weight rating, and I'm just reading from the actual Ram tow chart here, is 11,800 pounds with a payload of 4,340. But to get your exact readings, you're gonna wanna look at the little sticker inside the driver's side door jamb, because that sticker is specific to your truck and all the features that are put on it. So even though I can look at the tow chart and say this payload capacity is 4,340 pounds, the sticker on my door, because of all the extra options and equipment we have installed, is actually only about 3,900 pounds. We went with the extra long running boards. They go wheel to wheel, which is really nice for accessing the bed. We have all the other bells and whistles, the electronics. We have the air suspension in the back. So all those things add weight to your vehicle, which is gonna lower the overall capacity. So if you want the highest payload capacity possible, you basically have to get a very stripped down truck. You don't want all the bells and whistles. You don't want all those extra things that can make it more comfortable. So for now, this truck, yes, is overkill with my lightweight travel trailer. We have hitched it up. We have gone places with it already. It's like it's not even back there. The engine doesn't even act any different. It only squats an inch to an inch and a half, and then the air suspension kicks in and raises it right back up. It's an auto level system. So when you hitch something up and it squats a little bit, it's gonna automatically inflate it to the right pressure to get you riding level. Love it. I went for that upgrade instead of the sunroof. So yes, I miss the sunroof, but I wouldn't trade that air suspension for anything when I'm towing. The other thing it does, I've noticed, I've driven the trucks that don't have the air suspension, it's actually a much smoother ride with the air suspension on there. So it does make a little bit of difference even when you're not under load. But when you're loaded, night and day, drive level, don't have to worry about anything. So the other numbers to bring up would be the trailering capacity. How much can you actually tow with this? Well, this particular setup that we have is just a hair under 20,000 pounds that we can tow. The gross combined weight rating, however, is 28,300 pounds. What the gross combined weight rating is the total that your truck and trailer together combined, hence the name, can weigh. You cannot exceed that limit. You'd be setting yourself up to lawsuits, insurance issues, all kinds of problems. So you have to stay under that number. It's not all about just the trailer weight. You have to consider both together. So that's the truck with all contents, cargo, people. In my case, we have 6 people in the family. So we have to take all that into consideration with the weight combined with the weight of the loaded trailer. You have to stay under that gross combined weight rate. You have to think about all these different numbers. Basically, just because you have a Ram 3500 or a Ford F-350 or a Chevy 3500, it doesn't matter what brand of truck you go with, all of these numbers are extremely important to consider. You never want to overlook these. And on that note, one truck is not necessarily better than the other. Everybody has their opinions. I just happen to go from a Ram to a Ram because I've had good experience with them. The numbers and what they've been doing these days with the towing features, loved it. I did look at and drive other trucks, but this is the one that won me over with all the features. It has all the bells and whistles we could need. You've got your alternate trailer height, which I really don't use because it's supposed to lower the bed down. But I've noticed when I hit it, it only lowers it by an inch or two. It's nothing significant. So I don't even really need that. It's kind of an irrelevant feature to me. The other extremely important one is the electronic brake controller. Heavy duty trucks are built for trailering. They're built for hauling. So they're usually gonna have it built in. So an integrated brake controller is really nice. You can adjust the gain. You can apply it whenever you need to, or you can just allow it to work with your truck's brakes to apply the trailer brakes every time you're stopping. I also really like the fact that the diesel has the exhaust brake, and Ram has done an awesome job with the exhaust brake. There are 2 different settings. There's the full setting and there's auto. Full is basically going to engage the exhaust brake whenever I'm not accelerating. So it's gonna try to slow you down all the time. So I like automatic. As soon as I even tap those brakes, it's gonna kick in the exhaust brake and start slowing me down. If you're using cruise control or even just going down a hill and it can tell it's picking up speed, it kicks in and slows it down. So you don't wanna fully rely on the exhaust brake. You still need your regular brakes and the trailer brakes, obviously. But when towing, an exhaust brake, such a nice feature to have. Absolutely love it. The other thing I love about this truck, the surround camera view. I have a camera basically on every side, corner, back, on the mirrors. There's cameras everywhere. So it'll stitch them all together and give me an aerial view. Very helpful when you're in a tight spot, because if you've ever driven a heavy duty truck, you know they don't have the most wonderful turn radius, unless you go with an F450, that's another story. And they're just big vehicles, so any assistance you can get to see where you are and how much clearance you have, 2 thumbs up. The other nice thing about it is there is a camera in the bed, and there's one in the tailgate, actually 2 or 3 in the tailgate, so it gives me all kinds of different angles for actually hitching up a trailer. I can zoom in, zoom out, do whatever I need to do so I can get that view, and actually it's made hitching up basically a one-person job. I can figure it out myself. I kind of did anyway just by guessing, but now I know and I can see with all these cameras. Amazing. The other thing I really like is not having to manually adjust the convex mirrors. With just a flip of a switch, I can change over and adjust any mirror that I want to. Either the 2 main side mirrors or the convex mirrors, I can do that myself. It's no more guessing games or having my wife stick her arm out the window to adjust the mirror and get it just right. Love it. So it's the little things that I like. Also, they fold in automatically. So in a tight parking spot, you can fold those mirrors in. And actually, I have to do it just to get it in the garage that I have. My garage is too narrow. Another reason I didn't go with a dually. Couldn't even put it in the garage if I wanted to. So with all that being said, we've actually already gone on a couple camping trips in this truck. We've seen how it tows. We've seen the benefits of having the larger truck. I will not go back to a smaller truck. But having said that, I absolutely loved my Ram 1500. It did the job, it got us to where we needed to go. It pulled my trailer beautifully. We just had an opportunity to upgrade our truck, so we figured instead of just going one more level up, we went all the way. We went to the 3500, basically future-proofing ourselves in case we ever want to upgrade, get a bigger trailer, or more likely, a fifth wheel. If you've seen any of our other videos when we're touring, you know, at the different RV shows, we love looking at fifth wheels. We really like the setup of those and the feel of them. It would be a totally different towing experience, much larger trailer than what I'm dealing with now, but it is what we're interested in. The size of our family, that's probably going to be our next move. So when that does happen, we will keep you posted. We will let you know. But until that day comes, we're going to enjoy the trailer we have. And we actually already have some content that we filmed from fall of 2019. A couple trips that we did that we still haven't even released yet. So a little bit of a backlog, a little behind, simply because I do work full time. Winter is one of my busiest times of the year, so I get a little behind. But more content to come from last year, and then also to let you know how we're handling 2020 with all these different closures, stay-at-home orders. Every state is different, so we're trying to finagle that and figure out where we're gonna go, what we're gonna do next. So we do have plans, we just don't know exactly what they're gonna look like yet. And again, when we do, we will release those, get it out to you. But no matter what we do, we're gonna have a good time, and hopefully you'll be able to come along with us. Check out those videos, see where we go, how we handle this. So don't forget to subscribe below, hit that bell icon so you get notifications when we do upload new videos, since we don't have a really regular content release schedule. And hit the like button if you like this video. And feel free to comment below if you have your own tips on towing. What truck do you drive? What do you think of it? What towing feature do you never want to go without? Let us know. Start a conversation. So that's it for this one. We will see you next time.